Good morning, children. In the previous class, I explained about exercise 1.1. We took up few questions, 1 and 3 specially. I told you that the prove that sums we'll take up later. Now, today we'll take up a new topic, that is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. You know what fundamental theorem of arithmetic? The name seems to be very complicated, isn't it? Very, they're having tremendous amount of weight. It seems to be something very, very heavy. Or maybe you might feel that it must be a big rock which is going to fall on you. But in a simple term, if I want to say, it is nothing but the prime factorization which you learned in your primary class. Okay, this fundamental theorem of arithmetic stands for the prime factorization method. In primary classes, you have factorized simple sums, isn't it? Like say here it is shown, no? 2 is 2 ones are, 4 means 2 twos are, 253 means 1123 are. So these are the factors of 4, these are the factors of 253. So like that, in the prime form you factorize, that is called the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So if such a sum is given to you, you can factorize it and show it, as I have done it for you. 2 sums I have shown over here, just pay attention over here. 1771 is a figure given. So 1771, how will you do it? 7 253 times. Now 253 will be 1123 times. 7 1123, all these three are prime numbers. First of all, what are prime number? The number which has 1 and itself as a divisor. There is no other number dividing it. 1 and itself, that number are called the prime numbers. So here the prime factors of 1771 is 7, 11 and 23. The next number given beside is 10626. So there 2, 5313 times. Then 3, 1771 times. Now this number is what we did over here. So from there the same thing is repeated over here, see. So finally 10626 will be 2, 3, 7, 11 and 23. All these are prime factors. Having 1 and itself as a factors. Correct or not? In the same way, if I take up few more sums here. This is another sum which I took up. 21252. 21252 will be 210626 times. Now this 10626 we did just now in the previous page. So that part is again copied. So it will be 21252 will be 2 square. 2 square means 2 by 2 hai. Then 3, 7, 11, 23. 3, 7, 11, 23. These are the prime factors of 21252. Clear? So this we have already done in primary class. It's nothing new. So in exercise 1.2. You are having sums of this type. Now there, I didn't pick up all the sums. Why? Obviously, they are very simple, isn't it? So, exercise 1.2, if you open up. Here, this is exercise 1.2. First question is, you express them in the product of prime factors. So, I have picked up question number 3rd and 5th in this section of the first one. That is 3825 and 7429 I have shown over here. 3825 will be 5765 times. Then 765 is 5153 times. And 153 is 351 times. And 51 is 371 times. 17 times. So finally the factors will be what? There are 2 5s, 2 3s and 117. So you write it as 5 square, 3 square and 17 are the factors of 3825. Similarly the next one, 7429. Will be 17437 times, and 437 is 1923 times. All these three are prime numbers. Is this point clear? So this is how you factorize the prime factors. Now when you factorize by prime factorization method, you must have also worked out in your primary classes to find out LCM and HCF, isn't it? HCF I showed you in my previous video with the help of Euclid method. Now we'll take up HCF and along with it LCM by the prime factorization method. Very simple primary knowledge it is, so it's just a revision for us. Example, if there are three numbers given to you, 6, 72 and 120, and you have to find the HCF and LCM by prime factorization, then what should you do? You will factorize them. 6 is 2 3s are, 72 means 8 9s are 72, so 8 is 2 2 2 and 9 is 3 3. 120 is 8 15s are, so 8 is 2 2 2 and 3 and 5. All these are prime numbers. So now you convert them into the power form. 2 and 3 will remain as it is. But this is 3 times 2 and 2 times 3. So I'll write it as 2 cube and 3 square. This is 3 times 2 and 3 and 5. So 2 cube, 3 and 5. Out of this, now you have to find the LCM and HCF. HCF means what you have learnt? HCF means it should be common. And if they are common, least power. Okay? So 2 is common, least power is 2 only. 3 is common, least power is 3 raised to 1. So 2 into 3 is 6 is the HCF. But for LCM, you don't take common. But if the numbers are common, you go for greater power. So 2 is common for all the 3 numbers, but 2 cube is greater power. So 2 cube. 3 is common in all the 3 numbers, but 3 square is having greater power. So 3 square. And 5, which is not there in the other 2, is also taken. So for LCM, it's not necessary that the number should be common throughout. But if it is common, you should go for the greater power. So it's not common, that means. So now you multiply this 360. So this is how you work out LCM and HCF by the prime factorization method, which you have done in your primary classes. So it's nothing new to you. So therefore, your second question of 1.2 exercise. HCF and LCM, you have to work out by prime factorization method. Okay, so let us take up those sum. But before that, I have taken up one more example over here. This time, in the previous case, I took three numbers, 6, 72 and 120. Now I have taken two numbers, 24 and 112. 24 is written 8 3s are, so 2 cube and 3. 112 is 16 7s are. Okay, so 2 raised to 4 into 7. Now, what will be the HCF and LCM? Here, 2 cube is common. Okay, out of the 2s. So, 2 cube, so 8 is the HCF. LCM, 2 raised to 4 is greater power. 3 and 7 are also to be written. So, it comes to 3, 3, 6. Now, do you know an interesting thing over here? When there are only 2 numbers given, there is an important formula which comes up. Relation between HCF and LCM. And that relation is this. HCF and LCM of two numbers is equal to product of the two number. This is a very, very important result which is utilized for sum. Only for two numbers it is applicable, not for three numbers, remember. So HCF and LCM, if you take the product, it is equal to A and B. HCF is 8, LCM is 336. If you take the product of the two, you will get 2688. Again, check whether 24 and 112 you multiply, you will get the same answer. So it is verified that HCF and LCM of two numbers is equal to product of the two numbers. Did you get it? Okay. So now we go back to 1.2 exercise. I told you. Second question. I have not taken all the three. I am going. There are total three sums in that second question of 1.2. I will take up the first and the third. First sum is 26 and 91. 26 means 2 13 times. 91 is 7 13 times. So HCF will be 13 because 13 is common. And LCM will be 2, 7 and 13. That comes to 182. So you'll have to multiply and give. But at the same time, in the second question, you know what is given? Find LCM and HCF. And then you have to verify. Verify means prove that LCM into HCF is product of the two numbers. Which I showed you just now with this example. That is to be shown over here. So see, I found the HCF. I found the LCM now. HCF into LCM, when I do 182 into 13, I get 2366. And now the two numbers I have to multiply, 26 and 91, I will get 2366, which means it is proved that HCF into LCM is AB. The third sum also same way, 336 and 54. 336 is 16, 21 times. So 16 into 3 into 7. 54 is 27 2s are. So 3 cube into 2. Now HCF over here will be 2 and 3. 7 is not there. Okay, so 6. And LCM will be 2 raised to 4 greater power, 3 cube greater power, and 7 which is not common. So this comes to 16, 27 and 7 product, that is 3024. Now you have to multiply 6 and 3024. What will you get? 18144. Take the product of 336 and 54. That will also be 18144. That means HCF into LCM is A into B. Did you understand? That is how the second question is to be proved. So I picked up two sums from there. Now the third question. Third question of the exercise says, find LCM and HCF by prime factorization. Here you are not supposed to prove. Why? Because there are three numbers given. And I told you, three numbers, the rule is not applicable. So 12. 12 means 2 square into 3. 4 threes are 12. 15 means 3 fives are 15. 21 is 3 sevens are 21. Okay, now you find the HCF. What is common among the three numbers? 3 is common. So HCF is 3. LCM, 3, which is common in all the three. Okay, because 1 power is only there. Then 2 square, then 5 and 7. If you take the product of all these numbers, 4, 3, 5 and 7, you will get 420. That is the LCM, this is the HCF. The third sum which I have taken up from the third section again, 8, 9 and 25. 8 is 2 cube, 9 is 3 square and 25 is 5 square. So there is nothing common, and when nothing is common, HCF will become 1. LCM will be product of all these three numbers itself. 8, 9 and 25 will be 1800. Is that point clear? So there are three sums. The second sum actually is 17, 23 and 29. All the three are prime numbers. So HCF will be 1 and LCM will be product of the three numbers. Clear? So 1, 2 and 3 questions you have already done. Okay. Now the fourth one. Fourth one, they are saying HCF is given to you. 306 and 657, HCF is 9 given. Find LCM of those two numbers. So for this sum, you take the rule what we learned just now, that HCF into LCM is A into B. This is the rule which you have learned. So given to you for the sum, A will be 306 and B will be 657. And HCF is given 9. So HCF into LCM is equal to A into B. So if I want to find out LCM, it will be A into B upon HCF. So A into B upon LCM, sorry, HCF, 9, 34 times is 306. So 34 into 657 will be 22,338. Did you understand? So that is how you work out the fourth one. Clear? Now, in that exercise, you are having, we have done up till 1, 2, 3, 4, I already explained. Fifth sum, as I told you, is a prove that type, we will take up later on. Sixth one, they are saying, why are these numbers composite? This is one number which is composite, this is another number which is composite. Now, what do you understand by composite number? Composite numbers are numbers which are not prime. Means it will have more factors. Other than 1 and itself. Prime number means 1 and itself. Composite means it will have more number of factors. Now if you take this first sum, what did you come to know over here? 7, 11, 13 in product plus 13. Means 13 comes out common from here. Correct or not? How will you write this number? 7, 11, 13. See, if I show it to you in the writing part over here. 7, 11, 13. Plus 13 ऐसा लिखा है. So this is product and this is plus 13. So can I write in the next step 13 common 7 11 plus 1. So 13 is multiplied by 7 into 11 77 plus 1 will be 78. Am I correct? Now 78 is composite. Therefore obviously this number will be composite. ऐसे यहां देखा जाए तो एवरीथिंग इज प्राइम नंबर बट द 13 कम्स आउट कॉमन सो 7 इंटू 11 प्लस 1 विल बी 78 एंड 78 इज कंपोजिट देयरफॉर दीज नंबर्स आर कंपोजिट सेम वे द नेक्स्ट सम व्हिच इज गिवन टू यू इन दैट सेक्शन इज मींस इन द सम नंबर 6 इज आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग इट डाउन ओवर हियर इट सेज लाइक दिस जस्ट अ मिनट लेट मी सी द नंबर या It is 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. ऐसा लिखा है. All these are multiplication till here and plus 5. So again as I showed you in the previous case, 5 comes out common. What is remaining? 7, 6, 4, 3, 2 and 1 in multiplication plus 1. This plus and 5 is out, so 1. Now this if you sit and multiply, 7, 6 are 42, 4, 3 is 12, 2 is 24. 24 and 42 you multiply and add 1 to it, that number will definitely be a composite number. Try it out into 5. Therefore this is a composite number. Did you understand that? Because any number plus 1 will definitely become a composite number. Okay. 3 is a prime. But 3 plus 1, 4. Composite. 17 is a prime. But 17 plus 1, 18. Composite. Did you understand? So here, this product, whatever you get, plus 1 if you do, it will become a composite number. Composite into prime is composite number itself. Did you understand the 6th question? That means... So that was the 6th one. The 7th question says that there is a circular path and Sonia is taking one round in 18 minutes of that field and Ravi is taking 12 minutes for that one round. Which means Ravi is running faster and Sonia is a bit slow in the circular path. Now they both are starting at the same point at the same time. The Onoka starting point same, timing same. But what is happening? One is moving faster, the other one is slow. So... And they are going the same direction. Means they are going round and round and round. But one fellow is running fast and completing one round in 12 minutes, whereas the other one is completing in 18 minutes. So, the question asks is after how many minutes they will again come back to the starting point together. Kyunki pehle round ke baad to Ravi will come quicker to the starting point and this girl will be 6 minutes late. Second round mein utna aur late hoga. But there will be one particular round in which they both will again come together at the same point, at the starting point. Isn't it? That means LCM is to be found out between 18 and 12. So if you find the LCM between 18 and 12, you will get 36 answer, LCM of these two numbers. Which means after the start, common start, after 36 minutes, both of them will again come back together at the starting point, together. Did you understand or not? So, this is how you work out this particular exercise. So, in this exercise, except 5th, I have finished the exercise. You will complete this exercise in your classwork book. Please see to it that you work out very systematically and practice it number of times. Okay?